dear student, this is Devang Shah from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. We have been learning the subject basic electrical engineering, and we have started the new chapter which we define as electrical installation, wiring and safety. Now why this electrical installation is very important in our daily life, because usually we are using all the home appliances during the day, like fridge, like refrigerator, TV, microwave, oven, washing machine, all are working on a high current capacity, where if the current somehow, some malfunctioning of the home appliances, and if the current is not properly, or the all these home appliances are, let's say, not properly grounded, so there is a possibility to this high current would be passing through the human body and will getting a shock. Now so far, if we start our first topic, let's say it's a electrical shock, where how you experience the electrical shock and what is the definition of this electric shock, where definition says that the nervousness of human body due to sudden passage of electric current through the body is known as electric shock. If the human body is experiencing the flow of current through it, that defined as a electric shock, right? Now how this electric shock depends on the following parameters. One of the parameter is called magnitude of current flowing through the body, then the time of which the current flowing through the body, then frequency of current flowing through the body, and the physical condition of the body of the person. So that depends on conditions for this electric shock for a human body. So if to remove this electric shock, we can avoid this electric shock by using a proper electrical earthing of this heavy equipments which can carry the high value of current, right? So let's define the different functions of this earthing is described here. To maintain a proper function of electrical system, earthing is required to provide the protection to person against the electric shock, to protect the large building against the lightning, and to maintain a constant line voltage, we required earthing. So this earthing line is very, very important. Even if you have a solar rooftop installation at your home, see, it also requires a proper earthing, right? So this is very important terminology to define here, the protection against the earthing. Now what are the necessity of this electrical earthing? Let's discuss one of the animation here, where the, let's say if machine is not properly earthed to the ground, what happened? So you can see in this particular circuit where there is a electrical machine that can carry high value of current which is passing through it. So here in this electrical machine, in this circuit, we are applying AC sinusoidal signal, and this current will be passing through this electrical machine. So we assume here the value of this current is very high, right? Now in this condition, this machine is not properly earthed here, so the overall circuit is even being earthed properly, and in this condition, let's say you are just sitting beside this electrical machine, and you by this way, if let's say some malfunctioning is there and some high value of current is also passing through the outer body of this electrical machine or any home appliances, and by chance if you just touch the outer body of this electrical machine or any home appliances, see, you will experience a electric shock. Why? Because this current which is flowing in outer body of this electrical machine will also pass through it, and you will experience a electric shock, right? And this earth, by that way the circuit is also getting closed by this two earth. So you can see here the circuit is also getting earthed by this way, right? So here the large amount of current which is also passing through the human body, and human body is offering a low value of resistance than that of the electrical machine, so most of the current would be passing through this human body, and that will experience a electric shock, right? Which is not advised to make it this electrical machine is not earthing. But let's say if the machine is earthed properly, what happen? Just let us discuss through this example, where this is the same electrical machine, and this electrical machine you can see is properly grounded here, right? So once we apply the AC sinusoidal signal and current, the large value of or high value of current which is passing through this electrical machine, by chance the small amount of current is also flowing in the outer body of this electrical machine. If it is properly ground, and even if any human by chance is touch this home appliances or electrical machine, right, it will not experience a electrical shock. Why? Because this machine is properly earthed, where the all the outer body current will easily get passed through this earth and make the closed path of this circuit here, right? So all excessive value of current which is flowing in outer body of this home appliances or outer body of this electrical machine is easily get passed through this earth and will deny. So even the human body is going to touch it will not experience any electric shock in this phenomena, right? So this must be very, very important for any home appliances or any electrical machines which carry a high value of current. At the end, you must have to properly ground, or you must have to provide a proper ground of this home appliances, right? That's why here earthing is required. Now let us discuss about the types of earthing. So before that, let us discuss in this condition is also earthing is required. Why? Because of the overloading condition. So at your home, see, all the appliances are working at the same time. Let's say you are using the iron within the same switchboard, you are also using the refrigerator is also operating, fan is also operating, and others, some devices are also operating. In this condition, if earthing is not properly provided, then heavy value of or high value of current which is passing through all these devices, in it may get damaged at the end. So if the earthing is properly given to home appliances, then that all the home appliances can be saved at a proper time, right? So this is one more condition where earthing is also required. Now let us discuss about the types of the earthing. So there are two types of earthing. So here the earthing can be done by connecting the outer frame of all electrical appliances or machine to the earth through a low resistance conductor. So ultimately earthing will provide a low value of resistance, right? Say, so provides the low value of resistance, that means the maximum amount of current would be passed through the earth and the human body can be saved, right? So why we use the earthing? Just remember this, we required earthing to provide a low value of resistance appliances to make it a ground, right? So there are main two methods of earthing. One earthing we define as a pipe earthing, and another earthing we define as a plate earthing. Now let us discuss about the pipe earthing, where you just see here, there is a one position is the ground position here, where we can start the installation of this earthing, or we can start the set up this earthing, where is from ground level to depth of 2 meter, you required a proper the framing of the earthing, and after this 2 meter, you required a pipe earthing with this particular construction. So you required a pipe of 38 mm galvanized iron pipe with provided with the holes of 12 meter diameter, right? So at the bottom part of this pipe is installed with the bottom part of this pipe is installed over a salt layer, and above that layer we have to provide a charcoal layer. Now why this layering is required? To provide a proper low value of resistance to this pipe. So if the heavy current is flowing here, so at the end this structure will provide the low value of resistance, right? So all the current is going to be decayed in a earth. So we set up this requirement of alternate layer of charcoal and salt in this construction. So this is the complete construction you can see here. This is defined as a pipe earthing, where above this, now we have to install this pipe on a specific cover below the ground line. So this can be near to your home or any industry. You can see there is a concrete structure is required. That structure is made up of the cement, and where a 15 centimeter spacing with 19 mm GI pipe, which is a galvanized iron pipe, is required to facilitate this earthing properly, right? So above you can see the cast iron cover is required. Just you to open it and you can configure this complete structure. So above that you have a small funnel, and below this funnel you required a small mesh of the wiring, and that wire is coming from the any home appliances. So you can see here for any home appliances, let's say here, and that particular earthing wire is coming here and it's inserted into this GI pipe like this way, and this wire is coming below this funnel and that will create a mess here, right? And this pipe is connected here with the complete structure of this earthing, where the high amount of current will be flowing here in this structure, and ultimately this complete structure will provide a low value of resistance and the high value of current which is going to be decayed in a earth, right? So that's what the complete construction of the pipe we use as a pipe earthing, right? So this is one of the type of the earthing named as a pipe earthing, right? Same way you can see from ground level that wire having the depth of 60 centimeter, right? So from here the any home appliances wire is coming to the 60 centimeter and it will be inserted in this particular pipe, right? Now the another type of earthing which is called a plate earthing. Now here pipe is replaced by a plate, right? So first we see the complete dimension from the below the ground is changed, where it is just having the depth of 3 meter, where you can now install this galvanized iron plate of 60 centimeter by 60 centimeter by 6.3 mm, right? Now here the pipe is completely replaced by a plate, where this is a proper specification of the plate, right? So we assume here this plate is having the 1 meter, or you can check the alternator layer of coke or salt layering is required. Like we use this layer in a pipe earthing of the salt and charcoal, same way here the coke air or charcoal and salt layer is placed here in the peripheral of this plate, and this plate is that complete layer of having the dimension of 15 centimeter, right? So by that way you can provide a low value of resistance for a high current that to be earth, right? Now if you see here, the 19 centimeter depth is required from the 3 meter depth, right? So from above the you can see the complete this particular pipe is available, and here you can see this pipe will carry the actual wire that is connected to the home appliances, right? So you can consider this pipe is connected here of 12.7 mm galvanized iron pipe, and above this structure you will find a cement framing or cement concrete frame is required. And again we define this frame by a tunnel, and where you can see this 19 mm of galvanized iron pipe that will be inserted. So you can see the above there is a cast iron cover that will be opened from the ground level, and from that you can see 30 centimeter by 30 centimeter framing is required, right? Now here you can see here there is a again a funnel, where in below the funnel you have a mesh wiring, or you can also adjust like this way, or straight away you can find the electrical wire from coming from the home appliances inserted into this GI pipe, and that is shorted it here, right? So by this way you can also provide a earthing, and this earthing is named as a plate earthing because the lower part or the low resistance of this earthing is provided by this particular arrangement of the plate. That's why it is named as a plate earthing, right? By this way the earthing is possible. Either you can use as a pipe earthing or plate earthing, right? Okay. Thank you dear students. If you have any question, you can write in a comment box. Thank you very much.